you guys, welcome back to the channel and welcome to another vlog. Today is a very exciting day in our house. Today is decorating day. We went and picked up all of our Halloween and fall decor out of storage yesterday. And today we're decorating. I am so excited. I look forward to this from the day we take the decorations down. I look forward to putting them all back up again. So let me show you guys everything. We have everything laid out. I feel like this looks like a lot, but I promise it's really not that much. This is everything. We've got our signs that go in the front yard. We've got our Disney Halloween Village. We actually just picked this up this year. This is the pirate ship. We couldn't find this last year at Costco, but this year they had it. So we picked that up. We've got our doormats. Brandon's mom just got this for Jelly. So that is so stinking cute. And then over here, we've got like our sheets and our blankets and stuff. We just washed all of this so that it's clean and ready for us to use. We have had a really busy morning just like cleaning the house and getting everything prepped to decorate. And we're about to get started. So let's just jump right into it. Have finished decorating and now I'm making us dinner. I am so tired. Decorating is so much work. I'm so beat from doing that. That took us like 3 hours and I'm not even done. Like I still have to like organize all the bins and like clean everything. Like I'm done putting the decorations up and now I have to like clean up the mess I made from decorating. So I'm tired, I'm hungry, and it is also like over 100 degrees right now. There's a heat wave in LA or just like Southern California in general right now. It's 100 degrees. It was, the high today is 107. It was literally like 105 when we were decorating. Our big windows right here, they're amazing because they let in a lot of natural light, but they also let in a lot of heat. So while I was decorating like that area of the house, I was so hot. I was like, oh my God. I was just like, you know when you're hot and you're just irritable and like I was just so overstimulated from all the decorations. It was so hot. I normally really enjoy decorating, but I think just how hot it was too much. And then my vlogging camera like kept overheating because it was literally so hot in our apartment. So it's cooled off a little bit because now it's like after 6. Not as hot, but Brandon took the dogs to the park so they can burn some energy because they've been sitting in the house because it's been 105 all day, which it's normally not. It normally does not get that hot here. Like a really, really hot day here is like 90 to 95 degrees. Anything over 100 is like not normal. He finally took them outside so they could burn some energy because we could tell they were getting stir crazy, but it was too hot to take them out earlier. So he's at the park with them right now. I'm making us some dinner. Speak of the devil, Brandon is calling me. Hold that thought. Hello? Are you gonna let him play? No, it's fine, I'll wait for you. Well, the food's not even done right now, so it's fine. I'll wait for you. All right, love you, bye. Anyways, I'm making us pot stickers and I wanna show you guys the sauce that I put over the pot stickers. I don't think, have I showed you guys this before? Did Did I do this in a vlog before? I don't remember. So if I've shown you guys this before, my apologies for being repetitive, but let me show you guys how I make the sauce. I have my pot stickers cooking in my pan right here, and I'm just gonna pour these ingredients just straight over the pot stickers instead of, like, you can make like a dipping sauce on the side, but I'm too lazy to do that because then I gotta get another pan out and it's just more dishes. So I'm just gonna put it directly on top of the pot stickers. So I have soy sauce, Japanese barbecue sauce, minced garlic, honey, and then this is gonna sound weird, but it adds like such a like yummy sweet layer, sugar. So I'm gonna just add all that in. I'll show you guys how I do it. And green onion is really good to throw in this too, but we don't have any. So I'm just gonna do the pot stickers, the sauce, and then some rice. Okay, we have our pot stickers that are cooked and ready to go. So I'm gonna add some soy sauce. And then we're gonna add some Japanese barbecue sauce, our honey, some minced garlic, and then just one or two spoonfuls of sugar is more than enough. And again, I know the sugar sounds really weird, but I promise it's so good. It adds like just a sweet element to it, but you could always skip the sugar if you don't want it to be sweet. And then I'm turning my heat back on and I'm gonna let this simmer for a little bit. Okay, this is how the sauce is looking after I let it simmer for a little while. You can see it's like thickened up a little bit. And then we just have our microwave Trader Joe's rice. And then I decided to cook us up some broccoli really quick. So I need to butter and season this. And then dinner is ready to go. To Target because we are out of a bunch of stuff. Like, I need coffee creamer and we need like toilet paper, like random stuff like that. So we're gonna run to Target. And yeah, I also said I'm getting my nails done. These are my natural nails. I just picked all of the gel off last night because it was starting to lift. Once one starts to lift or like chip, it's over for the rest of my nails. I think I'm gonna leave the length. I have said before that I am not a long nail girly, and I'm normally not because I tend to get like irritated when my nails are too long, but I don't know, I'm kind of vibing with it. They're not bugging me, so I'm just gonna ride this out until I get tired of them. Also, something exciting is happening tomorrow. I'm getting my hair done tomorrow for the first time in over a year. Last time I got my hair done was last June. I haven't done literally anything to my hair. Like, I haven't gotten color on it, like highlights, nothing in over a year. Brandon has like trimmed it for me. Like, he'll trim my split ends for me. So like my ends aren't super bad because he'll trim them like once every couple months. He's literally just going in and like taking a teensy bit off the end. So I haven't had like a true haircut in well over a year. I'm definitely gonna touch up my blonde because I wanted to let my natural color grow out a little bit, but my natural color is a little dull and I don't love it, but I'm glad I like gave my hair a break and let it grow out. And then I'm debating two things. I'm gonna talk to
my hairstylist, get her opinion and see what she thinks, because I obviously, like, I want to take the professional's opinion into consideration. I'm low-key debating getting strawberry blonde, but I do want to go and, like, brighten my blonde up a little bit before I put any red in my hair, because my hair is already kind of dull. I feel like red can be kind of a darker color, so I don't want to go in with, like, dull hair and then put a darker color on top. And I'm also debating getting bangs. I got bangs back in 2019 and I loved them, but I ended up growing them out after maybe 6 months, just because I got tired of the maintenance. I loved the way they looked on me. Like, I didn't have any issue with them. I just was annoyed with the maintenance. But this time I think I want to get wispy bangs. I'll put a picture of, like, the bangs I got in 2019. They were very, like, they were bangs. So I think I want to get something a little more, like, low key that's, like, easier to maintain. And if I wanted to grow them out, it's, like, not as big of a process. I'll show, like, a photo of what I had and, like, a photo of what I'm thinking I want. Again, I'm debating all of this. I might go in tomorrow and be like, I don't want bangs. I don't want to do anything. Literally just brighten my blonde and give me a trim. That might be what happens. I don't know. But I'm just sharing my thoughts with you guys. I'm thinking about it. I'm ready for a change. I'm really bored with my hair. Like I said, I haven't touched it in over a year. I'm bored. I need a change. I loved having bangs when I did have them, because I feel like a lot of people, they're like, I got bangs and then I regretted it. I didn't regret it. Like, they were cute for the moment. I just got tired of the maintenance. You know, maybe I won't be tired of the maintenance this time. So either way, and especially if they're wispy bangs, I feel like they'll be easier to deal with. But anyways, I'm gonna stop talking, do my skincare, and then we are gonna go get our nails done. Don't forget sunscreen.
Okay, we just found these pumpkin decorating kits. It comes with the paint. You paint your pumpkin. And then you, I want to do Oogie Boogie. Or look, they have Jack. Oh my gosh. No, I want to do Oogie Boogie. Are you going to do Darth Vader?
Should I?
Yeah.
Are we actually going to do that?
Yeah, I think we should. That's fun. Can you reuse them, like, afterwards?
About ready. I just gotta make the plates. Let's call Jordan and see where she's at.
Hello.
Hey baby, how's it going? Yeah? Where are you? Okay, so how much longer do you think? Do you want cheese and sour cream or no?
Sure.
Okay. All right. I love you.
All right. Bye.
Love you. Bye. So now I'm going to prep the plates.
great content, seeing how they do stuff. Interesting. Beach wave. Yeah.
That's just amazing.
I know. I love it. I think it looks so good.
It's the cutest ever.
Thank you.
Good morning, you guys. It is the first day post haircut, and I am styling them for the first time, which I'm going to get them a little wet. Oh, no, I need to. There we go. Oh, why is this squirting at me like that? This is my second time having bangs. I've had bangs before, and I remember the first time styling them. It's like a learning curve. You have to like learn how to style them. So we're gonna see how this goes, because this is my first time doing it since getting my haircut. I did that really quick. I didn't even really take my time, but Megan, the girl that did my hair, she absolutely killed it. When I first got there, I like sat down and talked to her for like, literally, I'm not kidding, like 20 minutes, and just told her like what I was wanting, and I told her that I was thinking like a Sabrina Carpenter type of haircut with like a lot of layers and bangs and all that. And she was like, because your hair is really fine, she was like, I don't think layers are gonna look like, she was like, I think it's just layers are gonna make your hair look thinner. And I was like, you know what, I agree. So because I already struggle with like my ends looking like kind of thin, like we did some like face framing layers obviously like here, but we left like the chunkiness at the bottom. And then I told her that I wanted wispy bangs that like would be easy to style, easy to grow out. She absolutely killed it. So, and then for the color, I just told her that I wanted to like take my natural color and make me a little bit brighter, but I still wanted to stay like warm and natural. Like I didn't want like an icy blonde. I'm a natural blonde, but my natural color's a little bit dull and kind of on the darker side. So she basically, I feel like this is like my natural color, just like a few shades lighter, which I love, like, which means the grow out, like my roots is gonna grow out really, really nicely and like blend really well. Megan did an amazing job. I'm so happy with my hair. My ends feel amazing. They feel so healthy. I'm like over the moon. I'm so obsessed. This is my haircut for sure. Like it just feels so cute, so fun. Anyways, that is going to be it for this vlog. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for hanging out with me, and I will see you guys next week. Bye.